All right, here we are back on our 12 and a half project again, and I'd like to just explain to you a few things about what we've already completed. Now, we've patched the center line up like we said we were gonna. We've put a 4 foot between the stem and the keel. I've put 6 new floor timbers ahead of the bulkhead, and some of the floor timbers, the one under the bulkhead and a few aft, have already been replaced. So it's floor timbered under the mast and all the way forward brand new. And I've put 5 new frames up forward. So now she's framed up complete up forward and re-floor timbered. And our next project is to fit a new plank in where this plank came out. And the next thing we're gonna do is fit a pattern for the plank in place. And I've got that pattern right here. It was a piece of 1/4-inch plywood, 5 plies thick. And I've run it through the planer just to whittle it down to 1/8 of an inch thick. So it'd be nice and limber and set well into the background when I tack it in place. So I'm just about to tack it in place. From now on, it's gonna be done a little bit differently than most people would do it. Now there's 2 methods that are the most common to transfer onto the pattern, and that is using a pair of dividers. Some people would put a pair of dividers in the corner here and make a swing on the plywood like this. And then when you're marking it from the pattern onto the wood, you'd make 2 swings back, and that'd be back where you came from. But the problem with that is that it puts the marks on this side of the pattern. That's exactly what I don't want to do. I don't want to have this side of the pattern up when I'm transferring the marks onto the material. There's another method that's really using like a spiling block. It'd be just like using a 1-inch block, and you would slide it along the garboard plank here and make a mark on the pattern like this. But there again, the marks are on this side, and I'm not able to put this side of the pattern down. So what I've come up with is another method completely, and I'm gonna use these little paper tags here. They're little label tags, and I'm gonna peel one off the paper, hold it up to you, fold it a little bit just to make it a little bit stiffer on the end, and then slide it down into position till it butts against that plank, and just press it in place like that. Now, even though that tag is on this side of the material, when I take that pattern down, I'm gonna lay this side down and those tags hang out past the pattern, and I'm still gonna be able to access the end of it and transfer the end of that onto the material that I'm gonna cut. That's the method, and here we go. We're just gonna put one everywhere we want one. Same exact thing all the way down. So now we're applying a tag just ahead of every frame at the bottom edge of the pattern and at the top edge of the pattern. The bottom one obviously shows you where the position of the top of the garboard is, and the top tag shows you the bottom edge of the plank above the plank that we're putting in. So we just move down, put another one at the next frame, another one at the next frame, then we're just gonna go and apply some more at the top, and then once we've got that done, we're gonna move all the way forward. Now, we're gonna start working at the very hood end of this pattern forward. We've applied a few tags to show the curvature of the rabbet in the stem, and we've cut one on a nice angle to extend off the end of the pattern to show us where the very hood end of the plank is. Now that all of those tags have been applied, we have enough information on this pattern at this point to remove the pattern and apply it to our material. And there is our pattern complete, right there. You're looking at the inboard side of the pattern at this point right now, where it was laying against the frames. Now you're looking at the outboard side of the pattern where I placed the paper tags. I'm actually going to be placing this pattern down against the material, the plank that I'm going to cut out, with the outboard side of the pattern down against the material like so. And that pattern now represents the inside of the plank that we're going to try to cut out. So all we have left to do at this point is to tack it down and trace around the paper tags, and we'll have the shape of the pattern transferred onto our material. We've got a nice black magic marker here, and we're tracing out the pattern now onto our material. We've got half of the marker up on top of the paper tag and the other half of the marker down onto the piece of wood we're trying to mark. And it doesn't look like a real keen mark until you remove the pattern, which we're going to do right now. And then you're going to see that all the marks look very nice and keen and perfect. The inboard edge of this mock is the position that we want to connect up. So we're going to take a batten and tack it along that line and draw a pencil line all the way around at the top and bottom edge, also the hood end. Then we're going to pick that plank up and saw it outboard of that pencil line in a bandsaw, and then bring it over to the bench and plane it a little bit into shape. When we're done, that plank is going to look exactly like this plank. This plank was already sawn out and fit into position. I've done this pattern work and everything as a demonstration for the camera. This is the pattern we just made. It's identical to the pattern that we used to saw this plank out with. So at this point, all we have to do is pick this plank up and fit it into position.